Hi, Beth Carson here. We're going to talk about ways to hire great staff and then encourage them. One thing you want to do is look for employees that are in it for the long term. Training staff is very time consuming. So choosing right from the get-go is important. If you're in an area like, say, Tulum, where people are coming from hotels, you know, from jobs at hotels and other tourism spots, and they speak English really well, and they understand that, yes, Americans can be a little difficult, then you are way ahead of the game. In my area, I can go into town and I can be the only white person there. That's happened to me many times. And there are only two very small boutique hotels. So the staff I have had have not had experience in the hotel market. What I've done is invest in having the trainer, the hospitality trainer for the hotel. She's kind of the lead maid from the hotel that's adjacent to us. I had her come over and train our maids, and then she did some quality checks when they were first being trained. Now they're excellent and they don't need anybody to follow up behind them. Another thing I did was I took them to a five-star resort. I actually stayed at a nearby three-star resort with my friend, and we took them out to dinner at the resort. We gave them some time on their own, and I asked them what impressed them the most, and they said it was the running water in the shower. But it gave them an idea of what the resort felt like. And while I'm not going for a resort feel, it gave them what people like on vacation and what I'm attaining, the feeling that I'm working towards. So it's very effective in that regards. The other thing I do is to keep peace in the neighborhood. I have been asked not to pay my maids any more than what all the other expats that live there pay. But my feeling is they are doing more work because they are a representation of me. And the last thing I do before I leave is hug them and say, be good to the guests for me. Be me to the guests. So what I do, and I cannot tell the guests this, I never tell them, but if I get a review or a note and it mentions them by name or says the maids or something, they get a bonus. And it for me, it's not a big bonus. For them, it's substantial. And the other thing I do is I invest in their lives. We're about 2.5 hours from the Capitol. And one of my maids, who is 45, had never been to the Capitol. So my manager, who also runs a taxi company, had just gotten this incredible new 17-seater van. So I got the staff and invited all their family, and we went down to the Capitol for the day. The Orchid Festival, which is sort of the state fair, but it's the national fair, was going on. And I gave them spending money, and they all had a really memorable day with their family. My manager and I went off and did some errands in the Capitol and stores that we can't get back home. And they still talk about that. They know that I care about them. They know that I'm vested in them. And that I respect them. And I try to do things that are fun. One time when I was there with a friend, she taught them how to make a pineapple soda float. Pineapple soda is very big over there. I find it disgustingly syrupy. But they had never had an ice cream float before. So that was something that we just laughed and had fun with. So my first recommendation is to get in the trenches with them. Show them how you want the bed made and actually make it with them a few times. There was one time when I was staying there and a family was coming and the maids were very late in getting there. And I was really concerned that the house was not going to be ready when the guests arrived. So I was in stripping beds, doing laundry. I was not and I'm too good for this. Now, normally when I go, I enjoy the services of the maids and I have them cook me breakfast and make my bed. And I really enjoy it. That makes the 24-hour journey, that is part of what makes it doable. But that day, I sure was sweeping and mopping and dishwashing and doing everything that needed to be done. And they saw me do that, and that made a big impression. And we were ready when the guests arrived. And it was fun because I was able to greet them, and I'm normally not able to do that. And then I think something that helps give them a status is a uniform. Our maids have beautiful sort of traditional clothing it's a blue on blue pattern, a top and a long skirt that goes down to their ankles, and it's traditional, but they look beautiful in them, and it makes them feel special and part of something. And you know, the guys have a shirt that I ask them to wear, you know, that has starfish blue on it, and that it's just, it's, jobs are really hard to come by in the area where my house is, and this gives them a bit of status. And then continue to invest in their training. If they live in a second or third world area of the country that your vacation rental is in, they cannot get Western expectations overnight. That is just too much to expect from them. So build them up, and what another thing I do is I send them every single email that I get that has feedback in it. If something went wrong, I send them that. If something went right, I send them that, and you know, great job. So they can understand that it's not just me. And one of the things I did with the staff that made such a difference, the maids were using sheets that were ripped and stained, and in their mind, they were saving me money. So they were doing a really good thing, and it was very sweet. And I did not want to reprimand them or anything, but I needed them to have a mental shift. And so I showed them the website, I showed them how everything looked perfect, and I said, I'm not your boss. I'm not the one who pays you. You and I work for the 50 families that come here a year and enjoy starfish blue. So they're giving a lot of money to both of us, and we need to make sure that it looks like the pictures on this website. And so that means everything has to be perfect. So now they're very sweet. They won't throw anything away until I approve it. So they keep things in the back closet. And then when I come there, they pile everything up on the table. And then I approve, yes, this is a stain. Yes, this is a tear. And then they divvy up the damaged linens among themselves. And they're very sweet. They're very loyal. I treat them with respect. I ask them about their families. I really care about them. So try to avoid going in with a very authoritarian stance. Although it's easier to come down from that than it is to be on a friend level and go up. I try not to be on a friend level with them, but to have a friendly working relationship. And it's a little bit hard to finesse, but they need to see me as the one who the responsibility falls with at the end of the day and who needs to give instructions. I need to impart it in a kind way, but I do need to let them know what's acceptable and what's not. But as long as you do it with kindness, you'll be respected and you will have the most loyal staff.